Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Advice to Think Twice. My name is Monica and I'm here with our daily advice for January 17th, 2018. Thank you very much for joining me. So let's have a look at what the energies are for us today, what we're dealing with and what we need to know in order to be able to use these energies for our highest good. As always, remember that this is a look at the energies that surround us, and so the energies will play out in different ways for everyone. So just keep in mind and take away the message of the reading and then apply it to your situation if you feel that it resonates with what you're dealing with. So the first card that we have the Queen of Pentacles, and this is the influence of the past on our current situation. The Queen of Pentacles talks about a time in our lives when we were thinking about the future. This is perhaps when we started to work on manifestation, when we started to visualize a certain dream coming true, when we started to pray for a certain dream to come true, when we started to work with the law of attraction or work with prayer, meditation, anything like that to help us bring a dream into reality. This is a look at the future and what we would like it to be with the Queen of Pentacles here as well. In hopes for a secure future, a comfortable future, a peaceful and happy future. Okay, and that's what this card talks about, and in the position representing what is influencing us from our past. And the reasons why we were looking towards our future and what we would like it to be could be varied. For some, this could be to do with, this happening because we found out we were pregnant, and so we started to think, okay, what kind of world would I like my child to grow up in? For others, this is potentially reaching that point where, okay, well, I did the whole career thing and I thought it would keep me happy. However, I'm starting to change how I feel about that. So what do I want the rest of my life to be? Or, you know what, I thought I was going to be doing this with my life and it's not really working out the way I would have thought, or it's not really fulfilling me. And so what would I like my life to be? And so that's what this talks about. In today's energy, we do have the Chariot. So the Chariot is a major arcana card, and it talks about a win, okay? It's a victory type energy. It's getting what we want. It's seeing things come together. It's getting that green light. Things are now falling into place. Things are picking up speed as well. So the Chariot talks about making significant progress today with whatever it is that we were envisioning a while back. So this could be, you know, getting a job if that's what we were hoping for, getting the promotion, changing our careers and starting fresh, starting over, getting out of a relationship and enjoying our independence, and having the opportunity to travel, having the opportunity to travel the world, having the opportunity to head a department, a company, to start our own business. Okay, we're making significant progress with that. We're seeing things align so that we can push forward at great speed. With the Chariot here, it does take focus and determination, and we may either be pulled in different directions or have multiple options to choose from. So it's up to us to decide which direction we want to go in, or it's up to us to find a way to bring together the different opportunities that we have, or the different options or resources that we have to work with, to bring them together so that they move in the direction that we want them to go in. And that's the Chariot. But overall, it's a very victorious energy, and it's also a reminder to keep going, to stay focused. And even if we have a big sense of win and accomplishment today, this is not the time to stop. This is the time to strike the iron while it's hot. So stay focused, stay determined, and continue to push forward. The energy that we're moving towards, the energy of the future, that could be tomorrow or it could be just days, weeks, months after. It's going to be different for everything, every different situation that we're looking at, okay? So we do have the Nine of Wands and the energy of the future. The Nine of Wands here talks about whatever it is that we're making significant strides with today, whatever it is that we're seeing some sort of breakthrough happening with today, we are well on the way of not only accomplishing that, but accomplishing much more as a result of that. So it truly feels like something is coming together for us today. And if we do what we are asked to do, if we make the best of it, if we stay focused, if we take charge and we decide how we go about things and how we want to use things, what to say yes to, what to say no to, we will start to go down a path, very hastily so, of success and accomplishment, not only with that specific job, relationship, goal, whatever it is, but allowing to bring forward a lot of other opportunities, manifesting more dreams, reaching more goals, okay, with this energy. And it's all with the energy, the courage, and the confidence, the dedication that we see in the Chariot today, okay? This is what the Nine of Wands comes up as. This is how much I've accomplished. This is how far I've come. I'm proud of this. I stand for my work. I stand for what I believe in. I defend what is important to me, and I continue to grow. Okay, and that's what this is. And it's all wands, and all those wands have what looks like leaves on them, so new growth, but they're coming up as fire. So more ideas, even more inspiration and creativity, more things to do, more opportunities. Okay, and it's all about striking the iron while it's hot and continuing to invest in what drives us, in what motivates us, and continuing to use our power, okay, to decide what we want to do and how we want to go about it, allowing opportunities to come to us, but we decide which ones we take and which ones we reject or put on the back burner. Our overall guidance messages, we have the Walrus. Remain vigilant about the current situation. Pay attention to signs and omens and let them dictate your choices. So again, remain vigilant. So that means don't rest on your laurels, whatever big win or accomplishment you have today. And it can be something very obvious, you know, like where you get the promotion or you get the job of your dreams, or you have a breakthrough with, you know, something you've applied for and it's been taking ages to process or anything like that. Or it could just be a deep sense of personal fulfillment that not everyone else has, not everyone else sees, but you definitely experience, okay? And this says remain vigilant. Now is not the time to rest. Now is not the time to take what we have earned and chill out for a little bit. No, now is the time to take what is coming, okay? To rejoice in that accomplishment, and then to look at how we can push even further, how we can take what is coming together for us and allow that, or come up with a way to make that push us to the next level, so that we keep going, so that we keep manifesting, so that we keep growing, and we turn one thing into plenty, one opportunity into several, okay? And we also have pay attention to signs and omens and let them dictate your choices. So again, we will be inspired. We will receive signs, omens. We will experience synchronicities. And again, it's up to us to make the choice of whether or not to follow them, of whether or not to follow through with something, of whether or not to trust in a situation. Okay, but we will receive signs and omens. So on the one hand, we have one horse representing divine guidance, and the other horse representing our own mind, our own confidence, our own ego. And I don't mean that in a negative way, not the negative side of the ego, what we want to accomplish, what drives us, what motivates us, okay? And the Chariot is so successful, okay, because, or the man driving the Chariot, because he can bring both together. He can make both work with each other, okay? So that is co-creation, actually, at its finest, where we are open to signs and symbols, and we know what drives us, what motivates us, and how far we want to go. And it's finding the way to blend the two together to walk that successful path. Our power thought card for today, we have, it's only a thought, and a thought can be changed. I am not limited by any past thinking. I choose my thoughts with care. I constantly have new insights and new ways of looking at my world. I am willing to change and grow. So again, this is about allowing our external circumstances to change our internal feelings and mindset, perhaps. And by that, I mean allowing ourselves to be inspired and allowing ourselves to acknowledge any signs, symbols, synchronicities, and taking them and internalizing them so that they can help guide the way for ourselves. This is also a part that says, don't let the past define you. Just because something happened in the past, just because we may have made mistakes in the past, just because things didn't really turn out the way we wanted them to, that doesn't mean that we failed, and that doesn't mean that, you know, it's going to stick forever. Don't let past experiences hold you back. Use them as inspiration. Use them as wisdom, okay? To make different choices, to make better choices, to do things differently altogether. Allow your past experiences to inspire you as opposed to hold you back or make you feel guilty or bad about anything, okay? So changing mindset. Yes, it's very important that we are focused and determined, but it's equally as important to allow ourselves to believe that the universe is also trying to help, and allowing the universe to bring opportunities, to bring signs, to bring synchronicities into our lives to help guide us, okay? Because it takes trust, it takes faith for us to relinquish control just for a second so that we check in with the universe and what it has to tell us and how it's trying to help us, okay? So that is our reading for today. It's really a very beautiful, very inspiring reading. I'm definitely looking forward to see what the day brings, what the energies are, and how they manifest. Let me know how they manifest for you. Let me know what they make you think of. Let me know how they make you feel, how the messages resonate with you, if they do. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for all your support. All the yearly forecasts are posted, and I'm working on the February readings already. So I hope to be able to post them really, really soon. But thank you, everyone, for all your support, for all your positive thoughts and well wishes. I do appreciate them. Let's have an absolutely fantastic day, and I'll talk to you again tomorrow. Take care.